Eternal and all-wise God, we desire you to shine in our lives. Let your Holy Spirit take root, rest, and abide with us. Lord God, we pray that you will help me as I preach your word, to preach a sermon that doesn't just sound good, but does some good in helping somebody. We pray for the Spirit of the Holy Ghost to fall upon us, so that your word will go forth and not come back void. To this end we pray, to this end we preach, in Jesus Christ's holy and righteous name we do pray. Amen.
Amen.
As we begin this month of January, we're grateful for our steward board and special emphasis on our stewardship. And for a few moments, as we continue in the thought of time, our thoughts are leading to the Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses number 1, which says, to everything there is a season and a time for every purpose under the heaven. For a few moments, beloved in Christ, I just want to focus on living on purpose. Living on purpose. As we change the calendar from one year to the next, as we celebrate a birthday at the end of a 12-month cycle, it's a time where I believe each of us takes a moment to reflect upon those things that we have accomplished in the past, those things that we have intently and intentionally accomplished for God's glory. Some of us will say, as we look at the new year, we look forward with some thoughts of acquisitions of things that we hope for, things like a new car, a new house, new clothes, a new promotion, a new job, and all of those things, as we look forward, help us to think of success. But I raise the question, how are you living right now? How are you living right now? Are you grateful for what God has brought you through? Or are you looking forward to greater things that he has in store for you? We can declare and decree by the word of God that this will be the year of the breakthrough. There may have been some obstacles that we have to overcome, that we started one thing last year, but by the grace of God, we can finish it this year. Beloved in Christ, many of you may have received a little piece of paper. And I just want you to turn to that little piece of paper. On one side it says December 31st of 2016. Does everybody have that little piece of paper? The ushers were passing out this little piece of paper. We want to make sure everybody has a little piece of paper. Because at the bottom it says January 1st of 2016. If you don't have one, just lift your hands. I'm sure the ushers will bring you one. But I do want you to take a pen and write on the top of the other side, January 1st, 2016, and write at the bottom, December 31st of 2016. Because this reflects your life. This blank piece of paper reflects your life. And it's up to you how you spend your time, how you use your time, which will determine those things that you will accomplish. And then you can look back and wonder how God has brought you through those things. What is it that you're expecting God to do for you this year? What is it are you determined that you will accomplish this year? What is it have you already purposed in your spirit this year to fulfill? What has God already spoken to you that said that you put your hands in a plow and don't look back? He'll help you overcome. This biblical text reminds us that Solomon is telling us that to everything there is a time and a season for our lives. Don't you remember when you were a little kid, you looked forward to the snow, and when you were 3 and 4 years old, when the snow came, that means just a snow day. You didn't have to go to school, and you got to play in the snow. I don't know about you, but the older I get, the more I appreciate the snow. Those snow days, federal government closed, shut down. Hallelujah, somebody. Can't say amen, just say out. In this biblical text, Solomon is reminding us that there are seasons in our lives and there's a purpose for every season that takes place. He's reminding us that we must understand that there's a purpose for our lives and we need not use our time unwisely.
and you were able to grow everything. Yes, money sometimes grows on trees, but time does not grow on trees. And the Department of Treasury, while they can make money, they can't make time. And that's why it's important for us to use our time wisely. Solomon is reminding us in Ecclesiastes that Solomon is speaking here, and he says that time is defined as a valuable thing. Just think about it when you're sitting in the airport for 6 hours waiting for a plane. Just think about it when you're 2 minutes late and that gate door is already closed and the plane is already taken off. Just think about it when you ran through that red light and you see that little ticket that comes in the mail. Time is something that is valuable and is precious. There is a time, he tells us in this scripture, for healing. There's a time in the scriptures for repairing relationships. There's a time that we ought to laugh, and there's time when we ought to cry. There's a time where we feel God's providence, and there's a time where we can reward God for all he has done. There's a time for sorrow. There's a time for mourning. There's a time to speak, and there's a time to be quiet. This text reminds us that if we're going to live on purpose, we've got to use our time wisely. The first thing we can learn from this biblical text is that as we begin a new year, we're also beginning a new season. And this new season brings about change. That's the wonderful thing about time. It brings forth change. Have you noticed how the weather has changed? Notice it was 40 degrees this morning. Some areas it was 33. My little crocuses think this is 80 degrees. That's why they started blooming. They don't even know what time it is. But change is inevitable. It's going to happen. Just look in the mirror. Change has happened. If we look today and we learn that over the last year, even last week, there's some things that have changed, constantly changing. The question is, are we going to move with the change? Here in this biblical text, we heard in the reading of the gospel according to St. Matthew chapter 4, it talked about Peter. And in his life, there was suddenly and immediately a change that took place. Jesus was just walking by, and he saw that Peter was fishing for fish. And he said, "What? Come, follow me." So Jesus, Peter, and all the other disciples just dropped their nets, and they began to follow him. How Jesus just spoke into Peter's spirit, that was immediate change for his life. No longer was he a fisher of fish. He now becomes a fisher of men. He has a new purpose for his life. He has a new responsibility for all that he does. And Jesus is still, like he spoke to Peter, he's speaking to you. And he's telling you there's things that he's empowered you to do. There's places he's empowered you to go. There's accomplishment that he has in store for you to overcome. He says, he speaks his word. And the word of God says immediately, as he spoke his word, he made Peter a fisher of men. Jesus is speaking to your spirit. And as he speaks into your spirit, that word make, from the Greek, it means to sprout forward. There's a miracle that takes place as Jesus speaks into your spirit. It helps you to overcome every obstacle given to your hand. As Jesus speaks into your spirit, he's able to make those straight, crooked places straight. As Jesus speaks into your spirit, he's able to empower you with wisdom to overcome every task given to your hand. You've got to understand, beloved in Christ, we're beginning a new year, and Jesus is speaking into your spirit so you can use your time wisely to serve him in spirit and in truth. So this year, step into a new season filled with changes. This word of God also reminds us that as we step into a new season, that not only do we have new changes, but we also have new challenges. We also have new challenges in us. Has anybody felt the challenges of last year trying to creep into this year? As you go higher and higher, there's a devil that's trying to get higher and higher in you. But you got to understand from whose you are and whose you belong. You got to understand with every challenge, God makes a way of escape. He's saying to Peter, if you have some challenges, out of the storm that was in the boat, and then he walked on the water. That was a challenge for Peter to understand. How can I physically accomplish this task? His feelings were challenged because one minute he was proclaiming Jesus the Son of God, and the next minute he was rebuking Jesus and being called by Satan. His tradition and his prejudice were challenged because he began to follow Jesus in Samaria. His humility was challenged because when he came into the presence of the Son of God, the light of the world, the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, he couldn't understand. If Jesus is all of that, how can Jesus get down on his knees and wash my dirty feet? Peter was being challenged because he walked with the Lord, and there are many situations that he walked with the Lord, and God began to challenge him in his understanding of who he was and who he belonged. But yet Peter didn't give up. He may have caused a situation wherein he confessed Jesus one moment and then he denied him the three times, but that caused Peter to do some self-reflection, some introspection. And why is it that we look at this biblical text? Because Peter is much like us. Sometimes we've been in the presence of the Lord, we've heard a small, still voice, and he's told us to go one way, and yet we want to go another. This text reminds us that although Peter may have denied the Lord, Peter still had to confess that he loved the Lord, and that he was willing to be that vessel that Jesus could depend on, because Jesus ultimately said, Peter, upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not fall against it. So, beloved in Christ, yes, there are times in our spiritual lives when we may be high with the Lord, and yes, there are times when we may be low with the Lord, but in the midst of our spiritual challenges, we've got to understand that no matter if we're high with the Lord or low with the Lord, we're still in the presence of the Lord. And so no matter what challenge we may go through this year, we may lose a job over here, but the good news is as one door closes, God will open up another. Oh, we've got to understand our heart may be broken one day, but God promises that he will wipe away every tear in the midnight hour. Yes, we will have challenges, but the good news is no matter if we're going in the storm, if we find ourselves in the middle of the storm, or if we're coming out of a storm, we've got to know we've got God right there with us in the middle, coming out and going in. This text reminds us that as we live on purpose, we will have new changes, new challenges, but most importantly, beloved in God, this text reminds us that this season brings about new champions. I believe it was in 2009, Israel halted a new breed, wrote that song. It's a new season. It's a new day. A fresh anointing. It's coming my way. I know I'm not right there yet.
keep on looking to the hills.
Yes.
Keep on pressing forward. Keep on moving forward.
Yes.
It's a new season.
Yes, it is.
It's a new day, a fresh anointing is coming my way. It's a new season. broken body and his blood, in the sacrifice of the Holy Communion, as